And I want to conclude this lesson with three takeaway messages. The first one is that having an effective architecture is fundamental in a software project. Or, as I say here, a great architecture is a ticket to a successful project. To put it in a different way, although a great architecture does not guarantee that your project will be successful, having a poor architecture will make it much more difficult for your project to be successful. The second message is that an architecture cannot come about in a vacuum. You need to understand the domain of the problem that you're trying to solve in order to define an architectural solution that fits the characteristics of the problem. So a great architecture reflects a deep understanding of the problem domain. And finally, a great architecture is likely to combine aspects of several simpler architectures. It is typical for engineers to see problems that are new, but such that parts of the problems have already been solved by someone else. An effective engineer should therefore, first of all, know what is out there, know the solution space. Second, an engineer should understand what has worked well and what has failed miserably in similar occasions in the past. And finally, an effective engineer should be able to suitably combine existing solutions appropriately to come up with an effective overall solution for the specific problem at hand. And this is just as true in the context of software architectures. When defining a software architecture, you should innovate only as much as you need to and reuse as much as you can. As we said earlier in the lesson, by doing so, that is, by innovating only as much as you need to and reusing as much as you can, you will be able to avoid reinventing the wheel, you will be able to choose the right solution to known problems and identify suitable solutions for new problems. So ultimately, you will be able to realize an effective software architecture that will help the success of your project.